Before beginning this video, repeat after me. Natural does not mean better. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing well. For today's video, I wanted to sit down with you guys and I want to share my top 5 favorite natural ingredients for a DIY. Now, I know you guys love DIY. I love them too, but we have to realize that not everything natural means good for the skin. Natural can harm your skin as well. Natural can react with your skin as well. For some examples, lemon can be super harsh on the skin. Walnut shells are super abrasive on the skin. Coconut oil can be comedogenic. So you have to realize that whenever you're using a natural ingredient, it's not always meant to benefit your skin. And that's why I want to share with you guys my top 5 natural ingredients for skincare that you can use for your next DIY that are not supremely controversial and fairly seem to work well for a lot of people. But still, you always need to patch test anything beforehand, be it a natural product, a chemical product, or just anything. Moral of the story is you must patch test everything before to ensure that you're not allergic to any natural ingredient. And once you're sure of that, you can tweak up your DIY bit by bit to see what works the best for you. So yes, without any further ado, if you want to know my top 5 natural ingredients for your DIY, then please keep on watching. This video with my love, my forever and ever Multani Mitti. I have loved Multani Mitti since a long time. We are just in a relationship. We are committed to each other. We love it. But I think Multani Mitti in today's day and age is slightly forgotten, and I really want to revive that because I feel it's a beautiful product. It just works every single time. It's just amazing. A couple of benefits of Multani Mitti are that it just sucks out all of the excess sebum and oil from your skin, so it's perfect for summertime because it just makes sure that there is no oiliness and greasiness on your skin. It also smoothens out the skin and detoxifies it a little bit so that, you know, your skin looks clearer and smoother. And overall, it's a nice clay mask, so it just ensures that your skin is firmer as well. So yeah, there are a lot of benefits to Multani Mitti, and the price tag is supremely low. This is from Khadi, but you can get Multani Mitti from any brand and even sometimes from no brands. You can just get them in blocks in market and they're amazing. They work so well. Multani Mitti overall is an amazing product. A couple of different ways that I like to use this is as a face mask, as a hair mask, as well as a body mask. And for all those 3 DIYs, you need just one other simple ingredient, that is water. You can tweak it up with a little bit of rose water or milk or curd or whatever you prefer, but the basic recipe calls for water, and that's that. You just need to mix in a little bit of water with Multani Mitti, adjust the paste to your liking, and use it as a face mask, as a scalp mask, as well as your body mask, and it will detoxify everything out. Especially as a scalp cleanser, this works so well because it sucks out all of the excess sebum, but it doesn't strip your scalp down so that it becomes flaky. It really helps in balancing your scalp out, especially in the summertime. Ingredient number 2 on my list is sandalwood powder or chandan powder. Now, I have shown sandalwood powder DIYs on my channel a couple of times because I really like this ingredient in general. Now, this particular one is from Sri Radha Krishna Gramudyog Sansthan, but I'm sure you can get chandan powder from various udyogs and sansthans. It's very easily reachable. Plus, it's not supremely inexpensive. It is slightly more expensive than Multani Mitti, but still very, very cost efficient as well. Now, a couple of different benefits of sandalwood powder are that it helps with hyperpigmentation. It also detoxifies your skin and gets rid of a lot of odor as well. I like to use sandalwood powder in 2 different ways, as a face mask as well as a body mask. And you again need just one simple ingredient, that is water, with it, and it becomes like a nice powdery paste. It's not as smooth as Multani Mitti, so it can get slightly messy, so I would recommend you using this when you're already in the washroom. You can tweak up your recipe with vitamin E or rose water, or again anything that you prefer, but basic recipe is just water. What I like to do is I like to apply this as a face mask all over my face, and I also like to apply it on my underarms because it is a detoxifying agent and it also has a beautiful fragrance to it. It gets rid of any sort of body odor, so applying it on your underarms really helps in having lesser odor from your underarms as well. I like to do it about 2x a week so that my underarms are nice and fresh, and it also does not sting on freshly shaved underarms, so that's a plus point. So overall, sandalwood powder from my side is something you should be trying out for your next DIY if you haven't already. Moving on to Arita powder. Now, this is something that our nannies and dadis have loved and we have completely forgotten. This particular one is from Adore Naturals, but again, I'm sure you can get Arita powder from different brands. Arita is a natural wash, so you can use it as a hair wash as well as your body wash. It does get rid of a lot of toxins, but what you have to keep in mind is if you're using this as a hair wash, your hair shouldn't be supremely oiled. You can just use it as a hair wash on your oily hair, but if you have a really heavy and thick oil on your hair, this wouldn't get rid of most of it, and you would require a little bit of sud ingredient or a little bit of sulfates to get rid of excessive oil on your scalp. So use this when your hair gets naturally greasy and naturally oily to get rid of that and wash your hair with a natural wash. Benefits of Arita powder are that it's a very nice cleanser. It's a nice and gentle cleanser. So it cleanses your scalp and your skin of dust, grime and other ingredients, but it does not strip it down. It makes sure that the natural moisture is there and it's not stripped down so that it feels dry and creates flakes on your scalp. So that's the biggest benefit of Arita. It's a natural cleanser but not stripping on the skin. The way that you have to supposed to use this again is mix it in with water, but make sure that you create it as a thicker paste, like a yogurt consistency, and then just apply it on your scalp and your body to create a natural wash for your hair and body. Next up on our list is the last powder, and we have Shikhakai powder. Again, this is something that our nannies and dadis loved and we have completely forgotten. Now, this is amazing for your hair. It works as a great hair mask. The benefits of this is that it just prevents hair fall and dandruff, and it promotes supremely healthy hair growth. It moisturizes your hair and makes it appear shiny, soft and smooth. It's very easy to use. Again, all you need to do is just add a little bit of water, tweak it up once you are completely sure of the ingredient, but just apply it with a little bit of water, mix it in with a little bit of water, apply on your scalp as well as on your hair length. Applying on the hair length is super important. Wait for about 15 to 20 minutes and after that just rinse it off, wash it off, and you would be left with super shiny, smooth hair. Last up on our list is something that the world loves. We have aloe vera gel with us. Now, this particular one is from Jeva, but there are multiple companies and you don't even need a company, to be honest, to have aloe vera gel. You can just have a plant at your home and just drip it out and just apply it. But this works as a face mask, as a hair mask, as a body pampering session, something that will help you with sunburns or cuts or anything. There's so many ways that you can use aloe vera gel in, but my favorite way has to be squeezing a little bit of aloe vera gel into an ice tray and freezing it and using it on my face in summertime, because it cools down your skin and also helps in moisturizing and balancing it a little. I love to do that, but I have a whole spa routine with aloe vera gel. I would leave a link for you guys in the bottom bar. So my spa days are basically wherein I take one ingredient and I create multiple DIYs around it for a spa, whole body spa routine. But yes, aloe vera gel I think is the most controversial out of this list, because there are a lot of people who do not like aloe vera gel. If you are someone like that, try bamboo gel or lotus gel or cactus gel. I'm sure something would suit you. If it doesn't, you can obviously choose from the other four ingredients, because all of them are amazing as well. For aloe vera gel, you don't really need an external ingredient. You can just use it like that. But if you want to mix, you can mix any of those four ingredients with aloe vera gel and use wherever you prefer. And with that, we finished my list for my favorite natural ingredients for DIY. I hope you guys enjoyed this and you got an idea for your next DIY skincare project. If you use any of these ingredients in your DIY, make sure you let me know how you feel about them in the comments below, or you can even send me a DM on Instagram or tag me in your stories or whatever. I would love to see it. But yes, that's gonna be it for this video. I'll see you guys next time. Till then, take care. I love you all so much. Please stay home and stay safe. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.